The two men were ordained by the Buddha himself. From then on, Upatissa was known as the Venerable Sariputta, and Kolita was known as the Venerable Mahamoggallana. Both men faced a tremendous amount of pressure. Everyone knew they were supposed to be chief disciples, yet both monks were merely sotapannas, stream enterers, the lowest level of attainment. All the other monks at that time were at least sotapannas, and many of them were at higher levels. The two new monks focused on their practice. The Venerable Moggallana separated himself from the group and dedicated himself to his mental cultivation. He went to a town named Kalawalaputta near the region of Magadha. He reflected on the nature of reality and tried to internally grasp the Buddha's teachings. However, he was unable to focus. He was troubled by fatigue and lethargy. This caused a lot of suffering. He knew he had to overcome his obstacles, but try as he might, he was unable to do so. His contemplations were often interrupted by bouts of drowsiness. The Buddha sensed this and mentally sent a suggestion to Moggallana. He said, "If you are feeling sleepy, try the following steps. When you feel your mind wandering, focus on the thing you are thinking of. Contemplate this topic. This might help rid you of sleepiness. If not, reflect on the Dhamma that you have studied in detail. Try to look at it from various angles and find examples to support the concept. If this does not work, then loudly recite the Dhamma you have studied. If this does not work, then put fingers in your ears and massage your body to try to awaken it. If not, then get up and splash water on your face. Turn your head to and fro and look up and down. If it still doesn't work, then imagine it's daytime with bright sunshine. If that does not work, then stand up and contemplate during walking meditation. If the sleepiness persists, then lie down in the side meditation position. Focus your mind and try to contemplate on the Dhamma. The Venerable Moggallana heeded the Buddha's advice and overcame his drowsiness. 7 days after his ordination, he was able to fully penetrate the Dhamma and become a fully enlightened Arahant, along with unlocking all of his supernormal abilities that he had been cultivating for countless lifetimes. As for the Venerable Sariputta, he stayed near the Buddha at a cave called the Boar's Shelter, or Sukara Katalena. He faced tremendous pressure from outside and from within. He was foretold to be the foremost chief disciple, yet even after 14 days, he had not fully grasped the Dhamma. Venerable Sariputta put so much pressure on himself. He knew who he was supposed to be, but could not find a way to achieve it. This led to a lot of stress and suffering. One day, while the Venerable Sariputta was fanning the Buddha, Sariputta's nephew, Dikanika, came looking for him. Dikanika did not have respect for the Buddha and decided to challenge him. He said, "I am of the view that all things are not pleasing." The Buddha responded, "The attachment to not being attached is still an attachment. You say all things displease you, but being displeased pleases you. Attachments arise in the mind and lead to suffering. As long as you maintain your attachments, you will never be free of suffering and rebirth." When the Venerable Sariputta heard the Buddha's words, he immediately internalized them and applied them to his own situation. He was just like his nephew. He allowed all the talk to make him attached to being the chief disciple. His mind was not free to contemplate the Dhamma. He had created stress and fear about being the chief disciple. And this was exactly what prevented him from fully becoming the chief disciple. His mental constructs were the very things blocking his progress and causing him suffering. He was attached to the things he was thinking. Due to his attachment, he felt suffering. He was truly the cause of his own suffering. All things that arise from a cause will cease once the cause ceases. Once the Venerable Sariputta was able to realize that all of his suffering came from his own mind, he was able to release all attachments and become an Arahant, thus fully earning the title of Chief Disciple. At the end of the Buddha's sermon, Dikanika realized his folly and truly saw the Dhamma. He rejoiced in having heard the Buddha's teachings and declared himself as a lifelong lay disciple.
What did you learn from this story? We hope you enjoyed the video. Click like if you did. And click subscribe if you want to see our uploads.